Hello dear student, already we started the topic that lines and angles. Yesterday class we studied the some basic terms and types of angles, definition of angles and some important types of angles and depending on the vertical opposite angle on that theorem also we studied. So depending on that theorem today we will solve some examples depending on that theorem here. So example first one, in the figure line PQ and RS. Here figure they given PQ and RS are the two lines intersecting each other at the point O here. So both are intersecting at the point O if angle POQ and angle RO, sorry, PO, angle POR, this one, angle POR plus angle ROQ. So these both the angles are 5:7 ratio they given. Find all the angles here they give. Okay, we have to find. Only ratio they given, they not given a proper angle measurement here. So therefore, how to solve this one? So solution for this one. So already we know that one by the linear pair of angles, angle POR plus angle ROQ is equal to 180 degree because of the linear pair. Here OP and OQ both are makes angle 180 degree. So therefore, angle, we know that angle POR plus angle ROQ plus angle ROQ is equal to 180 degree. Yes or no? Because of linear pair angles here. So then angle POR is equal to how much? 5. 5 ratio they given. 5 they given means we can take that as a 5x. You have to take any as a constant here. X you can take, A you can take, B. Any one constant term you have to take. So that is 5x plus 7x. That is equal to 180 degree here. Okay. So then 5x plus 7x that will be gives us 12x is equal to 180 degree here. So therefore x is equal to 180 divided by 12 here. So 12 ones are 12. 6 remains 12. 5 is 16. So then x is equal to 15 degree. X is equal to 15 degree we got here. But proper angle POR. So that is equal to 5x. X value we got, that is the 15 here. 5 into 15. So 15 5 is the 15 5 is 75. So then angle ROQ. Angle ROQ. So because they told here to find all the angles here. So they told here to find all the angles. Only we got the x value. So we have to substitute here x value as in the 7x. 7x, 7 into 15. So 15, 7's are 105. So here 75 plus 105, again it will be 180 degree. So means angle POQ and angle ROQ is equal to 180 degree plus both the angles, that has to be 180 degree. So both this angle and this angle, both angles we got. So angle POR is equal to angle QOS because vertically opposite angles, but angle POR is equal to angle POR is equal to angle SOQ or QOS, that is equal to how much? 75 degree. Okay, so then angle ROQ that is equal to angle POS. Angle POS that is equal to 105. So because both are vertically opposite angles here. So therefore we got all the four angles here, angle POR, angle ROQ, angle QOS and angle POS. So due to the using formula, we can get the solution for the questions here. So only the ratio of two angles they given. If you know the common basic rule, that is both the angles and will become 180 degree because they are a linear pair, means that it's easy to solve this example. Good na? So we'll go for the next example. So now next example is, in figure lines XY and MN intersect at a point O. So here what will be line XY, so and MN will be intersecting at a point O here. So then angle A and angle B, the ratio of angle A and angle B, they given as 2:3, and angle POQ, they given this as 90 degrees. So then we have to find angle C is equal to how much. Okay, so here also angle A plus angle B plus angle POY is equal to 180 degrees, yes or no, because of the linear pair. So if angle POY is 90 degrees, it means angle POX is again 90 degrees. So solution, we know that angle POY plus angle POX plus angle POX is equal to 180 degrees because of linear pair. So but angle POY already we know that is a 90 degrees. Yes, this is a 90 degrees plus angle POX. First we will find the angle POX is equal to how much, that is equal to 180 degrees. So therefore angle POX is equal to, that is 180 minus 90, so that will be gives us 90 degrees. So angle POX is also 90 degrees, but in the angle POX is there angle A and angle B. So therefore angle POM plus angle MOX plus angle MOX, that is equal to angle POX only, that is equal to angle POX only. So then angle POM is equal to A and angle MOX is equal to B, that is equal to A plus B is equal to 90 degrees here. But A is and B is equal to 2:3. 2:3, the ratio given means we can take a constant there. So that is a 2x plus 3x, that is equal to 90 degrees here. So then 2x plus 3x, that is a 5x is equal to 90 degrees. Therefore x is equal to 90. 5 take that side, that will become a 5 divided 5. So then 5 ones are 5, 4 remains. Okay, that is a 40, 5 8s are 40. X is equal to how much degree we got? 18 degree. Okay, but we want A and B is equal to how much? So therefore angle A is equal to, that is equal to what? 2x. So 2x, that is a 18 into 2. So that 18, 2x is there na? 2x means that is a 18. So 18 to the 36. And next one will become B is equal to 3x. So then B is equal to 3x, that is 18 into 3. So 18 3s are 54. So 36 and 54 again you add, means you will get a 90 degree only here. Yes or no? So then angle A plus B is equal to 90 degree we got here. So but again what we need, we have to find the angle is C is equal to. For that we know that angle MOX plus angle XON. So this will be makes here straight line. Yes, means both angles will be gives us a 180 degree. Yes or? So therefore, angle MOX plus angle XON, angle XON, that is equal to 180 degree because of linear pair. Because of linear pair here, linear pair of angles here. So in angle MOX, that is a B plus C is equal to 180 degree. So B is equal to, already we know that one, that is a 54 degree plus C as it is, that is equal to 180 degree. So therefore C is equal to 180 plus, sorry, minus it become. So it will go to left that side. So that will become minus 54. So 180 minus 54, that will be gives us 126 degree. Therefore we can write here angles C is equal to 126 degree. So this is only the answer. So what now, how to find C? If they ask to only C, but without finding A and B, we can't able to find the angle C is equal to how much. So this methods we have to follow. If you know the basic concept, whatever the linear pairs, some of two consecutive angles is 180 degree means that are the real linear pairs. Some of the two consecutive angles is 90 degree means that is a complementary, supplementary. These all the angles you know clearly, means it is, this type of examples are very easy to solve. What? So next one. So now parallel lines and transversals here. So already you know the lines, parallel lines, which lines whatever will be intersect. So that two lines are parallel. Already I told here. So if M and N. So they will never intersect means these two lines are parallel to each other. Okay. So then what is the transversal then? What is the transversal? So the line which intersect two or more lines at distinct points here. Two or more lines at a distinct points, that line we call as a transversal. So here L, L is the intersecting line M and N at P and Q here. So at a two distinct points, so that L we call as a transversal. Well, not only the two lines, it may be more than two lines. So whichever the line which intersects the two or more lines at a distinct points, that line we call as a transversal. So when the transversal will be intersect the lines, there is some many angles will be formed. So which are those angles we will see here. First one will become an interior and exterior angle. First we will see about the interior angles. Interior angles here. So which are the interior angles? Interior means inside angles. So whichever the inside angles are there, that we call as the interior. Angle 4, angle 3, angle 5 and angle 6 are called as the interior angles. Which are those? Angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 6. These are interior angles. So after that interior angles, next will become exterior angles. Exterior angles. So which are the exterior angles? Exterior means outside. External angles. Which are the outside angles? Now that we call as the exterior angles. 1, 2, 8, 7. 1, 2, 7 and 8. So these are the exterior angles. So totally how many angles are there? When a transversal intersects the two lines, that time totally 8 angles will be formed here. 4 interior and 4 exterior. So except these, again some angles will be coming. Some more angles will be coming. These are just exterior and interior angles. After this, some more important angles, which are those? First one is the corresponding angles. Corresponding angles. So what are the corresponding angles here? See here. So then here 2, M and N. Two lines and L is a transversal. So here, one side, whichever the angles will be lies one side of the transversal, na, that angles we call as the corresponding angles. Here, one. Angle one is the above side of the M here and with transversal. So here, M above side is 1 and the N above side angle is 5. So one is corresponding to 5. 2 is corresponding to 6, 4 is corresponding to 8, 3 is corresponding to 7. Get it? So, angle 1 and angle 5, angle 2 and angle 6, angle 2 and angle 6, angle 4 and angle 8, angle 4 and angle 8, and lastly, angle 3 and angle 7. So, these are the corresponding angles. How many pairs of corresponding angles? There are 4 pairs of corresponding angles. Above sides 2 pairs, below sides 2 pairs here. Totally 4 pair of corresponding angles are there. So next one, so you can mark here. First one, second one, third one and fourth one. So next one will become a alternate angles. So which are the alternate angles here? So opposite angles. Opposite angles are there, that we call as the alternate angles. So here 4 opposite 6, 3 opposite 5, 1 opposite 7, 2 opposite 8. But in the alternate angles, interior alternate angles and exterior alternate angles. Alternate angles, interior, alternate angles, exterior. So next one, alternate interior angles. B1, alternate interior angles. So alternate interior angle 4 and angle 6. First one angle 4 and angle 6, and second one angle 3 and angle 5. Angle 3 and angle 5. So these are what alternate interior angles. So next one will become a alternate exterior angles. Alternate exterior angles. Which are those? Outside angles. Outside opposite angle. One is alternate to 7. Two is alternate to 8. First one is 1 and 7. Second one is 2 and 8. So these are alternate angles. So next one will become a interior angles on the same side of the transversal and exterior angles of the same side of the transversal. So first you will take a interior angles same side of the transversal. So this is a transversal L. Same side means this side or that side. So interior angles means 4 and 5. Same side of the transversal and 3 and 6 here. Interior angles of angles of same side of transversal. Same side of the transversal. Which are those? 4 and 5. 4 and 5. Angle 4 and 5. And second one there is 3 and angle 6. Angle 3 and angle 6. So these are the what? The angles formed when the transversal will be intersect the two parallel lines, otherwise two lines. When the one line will be intersect at a distinct point, two or more angles, that time whatever the line is there, that we called as the transversal line. Due to that one, how many angles will be formed? Totally, when two lines will be, one line will be intersect the two lines, that time 8 angles will be formed. So in that, which are those? Interior angles, exterior angle, corresponding angle, alternate angles, and one side of the transversal angles. So these type of angles will be formed here. So depending on this, some axioms and theorems also are there. So next one will be consecutive interior angles will become. So whatever the angles, so this, the interior angles already knew. Consecutive interior angles. Consecutive interior angles means the interior angles which are lies one side of the transversal, na, that we call as the consecutive interior angles. Otherwise the allied. Otherwise the allied. So consecutive interior angles, otherwise the allied. These only consecutive. Otherwise allied. Consecutive or allied, we can call these. So, which angles will be lies one side of the transversal, which interior angles will be lies one side of the transversal, na, that angles we call as a consecutive interior angles, otherwise the allied. Otherwise one more name is there, the co-interior angles for that one. Good, no? So now axioms. So some axioms on the angles here. So here axiom 3.3. So 3. What that will be? If a transversal intersect two parallel lines, if the transversal intersect two parallel lines, the each pair of the corresponding angles are equal. If the transversal means one line will be intersecting with two parallel lines, whatever the corresponding angles are there, now they are equal here. So this axiom we call as a corresponding angle axiom. So this is an important axiom. Huh? Corresponding angle axiom is important. Depending on this, so we will go for the next axiom here. So what the question? What is that? If AB and CD are the two lines, but they both are parallel to each other. Okay. AB and they must be parallel. Huh? Parallel, then only the corresponding angles will become equal. If AP is parallel to CD. If AB is parallel to CD. Huh? So that time whatever the corresponding angles formed. Huh? Due to this transversal. Here PQ is a transversal. Corresponding angles means angle 1 is corresponding to, name, give the name, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So angle 1 is corresponding to angle 5 here. And angle 2 is corresponding to angle 6. Angle 4 is angle 8, 3 is 7. So these all angles will become equal. So what will become? Angle 1 is equal to angle 5. Angle 4 is equal to angle 8. Angle 2 is equal to angle 6. And angle 3 is equal to angle 7. But the condition is AB and CD must be a parallel lines. If they are not a parallel lines, they will intersect at one point. So that time, whatever the angles, corresponding angles for them, they will not come out equal here. So only when the transversal will be intersect the two parallel lines, whatever the corresponding angles are for them, that all and corresponding angles are equal. So that is a corresponding angle axiom here. So proof of the axiom be not given, only the statement they given to study here. So next axiom, that is the this axiom you can call as a converse of corresponding axiom, because that is the totally opposite of that axiom here. So opposite means that we can call that is the if the transversal intersect two lines, they not given the parallels, they not mentioned the parallel lines here, they only told to such two lines, only intersecting the two lines such that pair of corresponding angles are equal, then the two lines are parallel. So what they told, if the transversal will be intersect the two lines here, so they not told here AB and CD are parallel, they not told that one, only two lines here. If AB and CD are the two lines and PQ is a transversal, so this transversal will be intersecting these two lines at two distinct points, the whatever the corresponding angles form, now if they are equal, here 1 is 2, 1 and 2 are equal, 3 and 4 are equal, 5 and 6 are equal, 7 and 8 are equal. So if these two, these angles are equal, then automatically the AB is parallel to CD. Yes or no? Here what they given, AB is parallel to CD. If AB is parallel to CD, whatever the angle corresponding angle forms, they are equal here. If here, if the corresponding angles are equal, when the transversal will be intersected the two lines, the corresponding angles will be formed equal, equally angles will be formed, then the two lines are parallel, opposite of that one. So that's why we can call as the axiom 3.4 is the corresponding the axiom 3.3 here, converse of axiom 3.3. So this is a, this axiom is the converse of angle 3.4, angle axiom, corresponding angle axiom, and this is a converse of corresponding angle axiom. Very important axioms these are. So here, some theorems are there. These are the very important theorems. So first, the theorem 3.2 from your textbook, that is, if the transversal intersect the two parallel lines, the transversal intersect the two parallel lines, each pair of alternate interior angles are equal. If the transversal intersect two parallel lines here. So here, if you are considering AB and CD are two parallel lines here. They are parallel. So whatever the alternate interior angles are formed, alternate means angle 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Here AB is parallel to CD and this PQ is the transversal intersect the two points at S and T. You can give name as S and T here. So whatever the interior alternate angles are equal. So interior alternate angle, angle 4 and angle 6, angle 3 and angle 5. Here what will become, angle 4 is equal to angle 6 and angle 3 is equal to angle 5. So what? If the transversal intersect the two parallel lines, that whatever the interior alternate angles are there, now they are equal. So that is the theorem 3.4. Only the statement is for the study, there is no any proof. There is no need to study the proof of that one. Only statement you have to remind enough. So next, that you got the, when two parallel lines will be intersected by a one transversal, whatever the interior angles will be formed, they are equal. So second one is the theorem 3.3. So this is a converse of theorem 3.2, means opposite of that. If the transversal intersect the two lines, but the statement is not a parallel lines. If the transversal intersect two lines, so whatever the interior alternate angles form, they are equal, means these two lines are parallel here. So if this angle and these two angles, pairs of angles are equal, means this whatever the L, M, R is there, na, the lines are equal here. If the transversal intersect two lines, the pair of alternate angles formed are equal, then the two lines are said to be a parallel. If the angles are equal, lines are parallel. If the lines are equal, angles are parallel. Sorry, angles are equal. Lines are parallel, angles are equal. Angles are equal, then lines are parallel. Opposite of that one. So this is a theorem 3.3. Is a totally converse of theorem 3.2 here. So then theorem 3.4 here. So if the transversal intersect the two parallel lines, again here the condition is transversal intersect the two parallel lines, then each pair of interior alternate angles, each pair of the interior angles on the one side of the transversal are supplementary. So what will be happen here if, so here AB and CD are the parallel lines and PQ is a transversal. So transversal will be intersecting the two parallel lines. Whatever the one side of the transverse, two interior angle of the one side of the transverse. So this is a transversal. This side you can take that side. Any one side of the transversal interior angles, how many are? 4, 5, 3, 6 interior angles. One side means 4, 5 and one more is 3 and 6. 4 and 5. The sum of these two angles is supplementary. 4 plus 5 angle. 4 plus 5 is 180 degree. Sum of two angles is 180 degree, means that we call it as supplementary. Only AB and CD are the parallel and transversal will be intersect that two lines now. So whatever the one side of the transversal interior angles so formed, they are supplementary. They are supplementary. This angle 4 and angle 5 are supplementary here. So already Euclid's fifth postulates you learned, if they are supplement, they are less than two right angles, means they will intersect. So here both are supplementary. They are equal to two right angles, means they are parallel. Yes, na? So then theorem 3.5, that is the total opposite of this one. If when the transversal intersect the two lines, not we can't use the parallel lines, only two lines we have to. When the transversal will be intersect the two lines, the sum of the interior angle formed one side of the transversals are supplementary, then the two lines are parallel here, opposite of this one. Angle 3.4 and angle, theorem 3.5 is the converse of theorem 3.4 here. So, what the line will be intersect the two lines, when the transversal will be intersect the two lines, the interior angle of the one side of the transversal are supplementary, then the two lines are said to be parallel. So, these four statements are very, theorems are very important here. One is the converse of other here. So totally four theorems, and theorem 3.3 is the converse of theorem 3.2, and theorem 3.5 is the converse of theorem 3.4. So the here all the theorems are completed, means whatever the basic theorems on the parallel lines are there, now they are completed here. Depending on these theorems, some examples are there, we will see on next class here. So still that you have to keep studying, solve the exercise, try to solve the exercise. If you are facing any confusion, so you can contact me. Thank you, students.